Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be doing a toddler room tour that I have set up for my 2-year-old daughter. I've incorporated both Montessori as well as traditional approach. I'll also be doing a tour of all the toys and books and all the puzzles that she has. So I think it'll be helpful for stay-at-home mommies like me who are willing to, you know, spend some time with your kids at home.
I was thinking that I should do a room tour for you guys. So when you, okay, let's get started. So when you enter the room, I've just laid out a mat for her so that she can just, you know, put her toys. And we bought this mat when she was a very small baby, when she started crawling. So I just thought it can, you know, be used for a few more months before I can clear it up for her. And then here is a play stool for her so that she can just keep all the toys on that and play. Like for example, when she's doing a puzzle or when she's playing with some figurines or if she's doing any sort of painting. So I just have a small table set out for her. And then she's a very big fan of Peppa Pig. So for her birthday, I had done a Peppa Pig themed birthday party for her second birthday. So I ordered a few mats from an online store. And then so I just kept a mat in her room so that she can just stand on it or sit on it or do whatever she wants to. And it's, and Peppa Pig, so she likes it. So this is how it looks. And that sofa, we actually, it was in the living room initially. During her birthday, we moved it to this room so that some of the guests could sit here. And she has a play yard with around 250 balls for as a ball pit. So that we moved from her playroom to the living room during her birthday party, and we kind of like that setup. So the ball pit is in the living room and then the sofa is here. So sometimes when she's playing around and she's not probably had a nap or something like that, I, you know, kind of relax on that and, you know, keep an eye on her. So, and this is a small wall toy. This is from the brand called Oribel. In fact, I learned about this brand, you know, quite recently, and I should have probably invested in these kind of toys much earlier. This is kind of she's kind of too old for this right now, but then still I managed to get it like in second hand. So she can just, you know, simply if she's bored with all the toys in this room, she'll just go, you know, play with this. See, there's a small lighting here. It's actually like a tree hole, and then so she'll just play with this. This is more for, you know, smaller babies, like from 8 months onwards, when they are, you know, trying to stand and play. In fact, but this Oribel brand has more toys for toddlers. Probably I'm thinking I'll invest in some more later. This is the bookshelf. Initially, I had a very big bookshelf, but what happened was it broke one day while I was trying to clean. This bookshelf I had bought during her birthday time so that I just had full Peppa Pig books in the living room for other children to come and read the books. But since my other bookshelf broke, I shifted all her books into this, whatever I can accommodate over here, and the rest of it are there. So she's crazy about books. I started reading to her when she was a very small baby so that she would, you know, get into this reading habit. So there are like mixture of books. I'll do a video about where I buy her things. And you know, actually, to be very honest, most of the things here, like this one and most of the books here and some of the toys that I'm going to be showing you, toys and puzzles, are all second hand. Believe it or not, they're all like so well maintained hardcover books, touch and feel books, or flip open sort of books. Like this one you see, this will have like, you know, flip the flap books. And some are like paperback. The problem is with paperback, she is still young for it, and she kind of tears it if I leave her alone sometime in her playroom. And then alphabet books and then picture books. Actually, At her age, picture books are very, very good because they've got big, big pictures so that I can teach her everything. And touch and feel are also great. Right now, she's kind of overgrown touch and feel, I think, personally. And then here are some books that I got from India. These are a collection of birds, animals, vegetables, fruits, because these are all very important for, you know, her age group. She's 2 years and 2 months old, so this is very important for her to, you know, start identifying all this. And then some sharing is caring, good manners, then please, how to say please, and all those kind of books. And this is something I got from India, from the brand called Shumi. I purchased it on Amazon. This is like matching. Now, they've got animal pictures and the children have to match. So that's something interesting. It's a very small one. It doesn't occupy much space. It's very affordable. And these are the toys I got for her when she was less than a year old, because of the music that comes from these toys. This is from the brand called Leapfrog. And they're really good quality, and the sizing is also good, suitable from 6 months of age. This is a teapot with cakes and 2 cups. And this is a picnic set. And it has like shapes, so it helps with shapes, square. There are 2 plates, 2 forks, 2 glasses, and a picnic blanket. And it keeps singing songs. So. So something like this. It's really good from the age of 6 months plus, when they start, you know, being interested in music and colors and all that, and even into toddlerhood. This will grow with them because they start doing role play, right? So she'll bring a cup of tea for me, she'll set up a picnic for me, and all. So this is the house toy. This again teaches children about opposites and different sounds. And she can, you know, press this button. It's the bell button. And then she can turn on the light and on off the light. Then she can turn this. Motor skills as well as language skills, it helps to develop. So this was also bought when she was around 8-9 months old, wherein she can hold and touch and press. And even now, sometimes when she's bored with the other toy, she just goes and turns it on and, you know, listens to different sounds. She'll do this night and day and all that. It's really good. All these kind of toys are like, you know, from, you can invest from the age of 8 months onwards till at least 4 years, 3+ years, they'll be playing with it. So it'll never go waste. I always take a lot of time in the toy shop to look at each and every toy and, you know, analyze whether it would be worth the money. I generally don't, you know, quickly come to a decision when it comes to her toys and books. I don't, you know, simply go in and come out with a random toy just because I have to buy something for her. I really take a long time to think what's how it's going to, you know, be a value add for her. And so now this stand is from IKEA. So you get these kind of baskets. So I've put everything inside so that it doesn't look cluttered up. And then, and you know, I can just pull up when whatever she wants to play with. So these are $2 baskets from Daiso Singapore. So in this box, I have all figurines and some Lego. So these are the Chota Bheem characters that I got from Chennai. Actually, my in-laws gifted this to Anoki. So these are actually really good for character play, and she, you know, talks to these toys. It definitely develops her language skills. If you know the Chota Bheem cartoon that comes in India, so you will be aware of these toys. And then these are from the Disney store in Florence. When we had gone to Italy last year, we picked it up from Florence. All the 6 Disney, I don't know what, junior characters, I think. So she loves talking to them, and you know, she keeps them on the different train, and you know, she takes them along here and there from the living room to here. So it's very interesting to see them play with these kind of figurines. Always ensure that the toys are age appropriate, because children have the tendency to put them into their mouth. So ensure that there are no small objects. Even if there are small objects, I always make sure that I'm next to her so that she doesn't put it into her mouth. So this one is all full Peppa stuff. She likes Peppa a lot, as I told you earlier. So she's got all Peppa's friends, characters and all that. And this also has a mixture of Sylvanian families that we get here in Toys R Us Singapore. So she loves again playing with them. She'll make the mother and the baby hug each other. I mean, it's very nice to see how children play. So this is some little bit of Lego mixed up here. And this was again gifted by her grandparents. And this has a mixture of My Little Pony toys. And this was a set, the My Little Pony train with the two little ponies. And it also has Bob the Train collection, about five train coaches that I picked up from Toys R Us. Again, these are all like were on offer. So every month when I go, I set a budget every month, and when I go into Toys R Us, I check which are all the toys on sale, and out of that I try to get the best for her. So, and these ones are the animals figurines. These are very, very important, because she learns how the tiger roars, or you know, something like that. She kind of arranges them in order. This I picked up from a very neighborhood store, and it was like very, very cheap. So then moving on, here are some of the puzzles that she has. Why I'm saying this is because she loves doing puzzles these days, and these are few of the puzzles that we have here. So this one and these two are I got it like from another mom who sold it to me at a very, very affordable price, because her kids had, you know, outgrown all these. This is from Early Learning Center UK. They have different puzzles, and this is from the brand Infantino, and this is a floor puzzle. She loves doing this. So every day morning, once she wakes up, she comes into the room and she tells me, I want the purple one. So she does this. It's a floor puzzle, and she'll say like, I did it. So it really, you know, motivates children to do more and more. So, and this box here has a mixture of flashcards and other set of puzzles that she has, and also some brain quest books that I recently bought from another mommy who sold it to me. These are like simple questions which are age based, like this is for 2 years plus. So like, what would children ask, you know, at that particular age? Like, what is this particular person doing when someone is coughing or sneezing, or like basic stuff like that. It's really, really interesting, and it's travel friendly. You can just put it in your handbag and, you know, take it when you're traveling with children. And these are some Melissa and dog puzzles. These are mud puppy puzzles. Again, all these are second hand, to be very honest. Here is the Melissa and Dog Latches board. This is actually age 3 plus, but still, since it was on offer, it was a new one. Somebody was selling it at a very cheap price, because they had two of it. Open all this, and she will, you know, spend about solid 20 minutes in this particular toy. It's not a toy actually, it's a board, a learning board, or a busy board, you can call it, toddler busy board. So it has like six different types of latches that she can explore, and colors and numbers and different animals inside every door. So she enjoys this. And this is a custom made busy book, or an activity book, that a mother in Singapore, she does it on her own, and she sells it at an affordable price. So I saw this on Facebook Marketplace, and I approached her. This was about $15, including shipping, I think. I mean, not shipping, just postage. Yeah, so this is very affordable and very interesting also. It can keep your child busy for, you know, at least 30 minutes. This has numbers and size and emotions and transport. Yeah, and animals. I mean, she's used it a bit, but it's really worth investing in such, you know, activities for your kids. Yeah. And then this is a weather and date thing that I recently bought. So like, I can teach her every single day. It's the month of May and the date. You can just, you know, move it and say, yeah, today is May 12th, Sunday, and explain to her the season, the weather, how it is today. It's cloudy, today is rainy, and all that. It's really interesting, and it wasn't very expensive as well. And the next two boxes have a mix of toys, nothing like specific, like set of puzzles or set of figurines. I mean, like, it's a combination of stuff, the leftover stuff. So these are some Legos again, which I bought from another mommy whose kids had, you know, outgrown them. And this is like a scribbling pad. Like, it's very useful when you travel with your kid. They can just, you know, draw. You can draw something and ask them to identify what it is. And then she has this Peppa's house, beach house, wherein she can play with the Peppa figurines. And then colors, some paint stuff, colors, and then some cars, wooden cars. And then here are some farm animals. So she loves this set. So she just arranges them and she, you know, imitates. She makes the sound that the particular animal makes, which is very useful. This is again from Toys R Us. And this was a toy that I got from Fun School in Chennai. This is a shape sorter and a color matching toy. This is an octopus kind of a thing. You press it, it releases all the shapes. So the child has to fix the shape and match the color. And these are some stuff from IKEA. Stacking cups. These are actually super useful for, you know, kids. Block. You can actually stack it, or like you can make a puzzle from it. Like, it has a picture, you can make a puzzle. Like, when this side you use, it completes a picture. It has numbers on it. You can count items. See, the same number and the counting. And has a flap. You open it, it's like this. So there are 12 square blocks and some triangle shaped blocks. It's like super useful for kids. I got it from Hamleys in Chennai, and these are stuff that my husband got it for her. He's a huge Avengers fan. So this is Captain America, Thor. So now, like, sometimes she even, you know, does some kind of role play and all that. She'll say Thor is going to fly and all that stuff. And then some other soft toys and a dolly she has here. So this is a must in every girl's toy set. Yeah, her dolly. So she sometimes, you know, sings rhymes and all that to the dolly. So yeah, these are the stuff that are here in the playroom. Apart from this, I do have some excess toys that are being put away in the storeroom that we rotate. For example, if she is like kind of exhausted with these puzzles, what I do is I swap them. Yeah, I put them all inside the storeroom and I bring out newer ones so that she doesn't, you know, feel bored. We've got some extra that will be useful because she can, you know, look at it like every time she's just bored or, you know, looking at the plain stuff. She'll just look out and she'll say, same, that fruit cutting when it comes, she'll show and say, same watermelon or same kiwi, something like that. So, you know, visual impact, yeah, some animals and some fruits. And then this is her, like, you know, before her first birthday, we printed out all this for month-wise, all the photos. And this is her wardrobe and all her stuff are there, like all her clothes. And yeah, towels, all the extra stuff that are there also, again, I put it underneath. These are the stuff that I have inside my storeroom. Like, I just take it out only when she's like extremely bored, and these all incorporate the Montessori method. The first thing is a kinetic sand. This is a very interesting thing for toddlers because they love to experiment with the different textures. So the kinetic sand is a very good a sensory play activity. So this I got from Hamley's in Chennai. So she likes Peppa Pig. So this is like you can build a sand castle. You can use molds to create, you know, different shapes, and you can play with all these cutouts that it has inside. And the next thing is dominoes. So of course she doesn't build anything with dominoes, but what I use this for, it has like different colors. So I just bought cheap felt papers so that I would just lay out all these colors on the floor, and I would pour out all the dominoes, and I will ask her to match the colors. So that's a very affordable and interesting Montessori activity. And the next thing is Play-Doh. So clay, like, it's very interesting. You can make whatever different shapes or whatever you want if you have the cutters, but I don't usually have anything. So what I usually do is from this I take out the turtle and the cutouts from this, the molds from this, and I use it with the Play-Doh for her. And the next thing is from IKEA in Singapore. So these are like very, very affordable cards. So this will have like 17 pairs. And what you can do, you can play like different games with this with your kids. What we usually do is a matching game. So I would lay out 17 cards for her, and I will give the rest of the 17 to her so that she can match the cards. And then you can say like a picture memory story. You can just take out 3 or 4 cards and you can say like, once in the forest there was a monkey and an elephant who were friends. So something like that. You can just, and then ask them to, you know, arrange which was the order that you showed them. Or you can just create an interesting story with these picture cards. So this is very, very affordable, and I got it from IKEA, and I have like 2 more sets inside. I just wanted to show one of them so that you can, you know, get an idea of what can be done with your toddler at home. So yeah, and then we're done with this. And this is like a super cheap Montessori material. This is just like a colander that I got from one huge set of measuring cups, and this again I got it online. So these are like straws which, you know, she has to put inside because it helps them with hand-eye coordination and fine motor skills. So yeah. And the next thing is I bought to pick it up at Penang Airport because Malaysia is known for their wooden toys. So this is an interesting activity for kids. My daughter has still not, you know, got the hang of it, but I'm sure that she, you know, get the hang of it soon. So she, it works like a magnet and they're supposed to move it. So this is again a very it keeps them busy. It's a busy activity for them. And this I picked it up from a store in a mall, from a China store or whatever it is. I mean, like, they have all these items from that comes from China. So this one, you just need to take out, okay, remove all this and fix this here. For example, I'll just show you one or two. Yeah. You need to fix this board onto this box. You need to fix a particular picture. They have 12 pictures in that. And you need to find this shape. So yeah, here you have a semicircle. So they will learn shapes, they will learn how to fix it. So this is a very, very interesting toy, and of course it's very affordable. Yeah, you can try it online if you are not able to find it in any of the physical stores. Yeah. And of course painting, kids love paint. So I got this Crayola 10 color washable kids paint from Toys R Us in Singapore. It was on offer sale here, so I got all this for around $12 or $13, which is very cheap. And this is another toy that I ordered online. It's made very easy Montessori material, so they have to use the tweezer tongs and to pick up the pom-pom ball and put it in the respective place. And I gave a small tweak to it. I also put a straw so that she can just blow the pom-pom ball to different directions. So this is also a very cheap Montessori material. And the next thing, I got all these puzzles from a lady like very near my place. She was selling all of this for $8, which is like 100 rupees each or $2 each. So these are like very interesting puzzles for children. So now like my daughter has become a pro in this. I'm planning to, you know, resell this to somebody at a very cheap price, because some families who cannot afford can, you know, buy this. So it has like this, you can remove these pieces and give it to them so that based on the shape they can fix this. And it has like different themes. One is marine creatures, one is farm animals, and the other is cute animals, wild animals and all that. And another one I have here is a puzzle, float puzzle. So I have many of them. I just wanted to show one of it. Young children find this very interesting, so I just give her the pieces on the floor and she will just do it. So this has like 24 pieces, so it's easy for them to, you know, fix it, and it gives them a lot of confidence. They feel like, you know, they've achieved a lot and something like that. And next, when it comes to Montessori learning, is replicating your real life situation. So we got her this for her second birthday. This is a wooden Japanese style kitchen set. So it has like a cooker and pan and sauces and an oven, washing machine, and convection oven. Yeah, so this is again a very interesting thing for toddlers. It, you know, grows along with them from age 2 plus to, you know, up to 7, 8. They'll be still interested. Girls especially would be, you know, very interested in pretend play and all that. So that's it for now. Let me put up a video saying how I, you know, purchased all this at affordable prices, so that it'll be useful for mommies like me. Thank you.